चोटी से फिर हमने ललकारा है, आज हिमालय की चोटी से फिर हमने ललकारा है। दूर हटो दूर हटो दूर हटो है दुनिया वालों, हिंदुस्तान हमारा है। दूर हटो है दुनिया वालों, हिंदुस्तान हमारा है।
It is fashionable to brand the traditional Indian film as sheer escapist entertainment. Those who have studied the history of Indian cinema cannot agree with this view. If we consider the work of a few enlightened filmmakers in the era before independence, this song sequence from Bombay Talkies Kismat typifies the casual yet forceful manner in which filmmakers introduced nationalist ideas in otherwise non-political films. From such an entertaining casual approach, the spectrum of nationalist films covered a wide range and included an authentic feature-length documentary film on Mahatma Gandhi, painstakingly produced by A.K. Chettiar by collecting material from different sources around the world. Our freedom struggle did not consist of a struggle for mere political freedom from foreign rule. The Mahatma conceived of it as freedom from obscurantism, freedom for the Harijans from oppression, freedom of the individual in every sense. In 1939, Himanshu Rai's Achut Kanya portrayed a love story between a Harijan girl and a high-caste Hindu, socially revolutionary for its times.
फिर भी इन दोनों के बाप एक दूसरे के बड़े दोस्त थे, क्योंकि
क्या हुआ क्या हुआ?
साहब ने काट लिया है, हमने उजा को बुलाया है।
An early scene depicts the friendship between their fathers.
अब डर की बात नहीं, मैंने सब जहर चूस लिया। मुझे क्षमा करना पंडित जी, मैंने तुम्हें छू लिया, क्या करूं, तुम्हारी जान जोखिम में थी।
समय के साथ साथ बचपन भी बीत गया।
कस्तूरी।
With the legendary Devika Rani in its lead role, the film featured a newcomer, Ashok Kumar. Prohibition was an avowed policy of the National Congress to liberate the poor and downtrodden from the evils of drinking. Master Vinayak graphically propagated the concept through his feature film, Brandy Ki Bottle. In 1939, Telugu director Ramabrahmam portrayed the ideology of a socialist society in his Raitu Bidda. The farmers rise against the oppressive zamindar and form an agricultural cooperative. Thank you. in his Telugu film Sumangali, B.N. Reddy tackled the theme of remarriage of a Hindu widow with a poignant, dramatic treatment. In these films, like Achyut Kanya, Brandy Ki Bottle, Raitu Bidda, and Sumangali, the progressive sentiments of the freedom struggle were not just casual or incidental, but formed the basic fabric of the respective themes. There were several instances where the themes were unrelated, such as a folklore story or a historical narrative where nationalist ideas were introduced. J.B.H. Wadia's Amar Raj is an example where a prince succeeds in overthrowing an evil king. When the throne is offered to him, he declares that the ideal government should be a democratic government of the people.
Praja ki agyanta se labh uthakar apna swarth aage badhana chahta hai. Wo rajan nahi, durjan hai. Desh ka neta nahi, dushman hai. Agar aaj maine aapki is divi padvi ko swikar kiya hai, to sirf isliye ki aapki seva kar sakun. Us desh ki seva kar sakun ki jisne us samay जबकि मेरा भाग्य मुझे घोगा से तूफानी समुद्र की लहरों पर लंका ले आया, अपनी गोद में बिठाया, अपनी छाती से लगाया, मेरे जैसे कितने ही इस सिंहासन पर बैठ चुके हैं और कितने ही बैठेंगे, नरपति और सम्राट आते रहते हैं और जाते रहते हैं, मगर आप जनता जो उन सबको ये ऊंच स्थान देती है, अचल है, अटल है, अमर है।
सिकंदर की हर एक लड़ाई तुमने जीती है। कौन कहता है तुम्हारी कोई हस्ती नहीं? सिकंदर अपनी सारी ताकत तुमसे लेता है। कौन कहता है तुम्हारी आवाज बेतासीर है? सिकंदर तुम्हारे बगैर एक कदम नहीं चल सकता। उससे कह दो अब हम तीर और तलवार की जिंदगी से तंग आ गए हैं। कह दो अब हमारे दिल अमन अमान मांगते हैं। कह दो अब हमारे घर हमें वापस बुला रहे हैं। कह दो अब हम आगे नहीं बढ़ेंगे।
Sohrab Modi utilized the theme of Alexander's invasion of India to instill national pride through the dialogue in his immensely successful film Sikandar, featuring himself and the doyen among artists, Prithviraj Kapoor.
हम खुश हुए, हमें आपसे ऐसी उम्मीद थी। और महाराज पुरुष हमारे दोस्त आप,
हमें अफसोस है कि हमारा जवाब आपको निराश करने वाला होगा।
क्या महाराज हमारी मदद नहीं करेंगे? महाराज हमारे दोस्त हैं।
हम आपके दोस्त बाद में हैं, पहले हम अपने देश के बेटे हैं।
वो आपके जवाब ने हमें मायूस किया है, मगर हम आपकी हुकूमतनी की कदर करते हैं। स्वीकार,
हम आपके जीवन के लिए जरूर प्रार्थना करेंगे।
और हमारी फतह के लिए नहीं?
नहीं, क्योंकि आपकी फतह हमारे देश की हार है, और जो आदमी अपने देश की हार के लिए मन से प्रार्थना और तन से सहायता करता है, वो आदमी नहीं है, जानवर है।
Few theaters used Tagore's national song, which was later adopted as national anthem by Free India, in the title scene of Udayar Pathe. The hero of this film has portraits of Gandhiji, Karl Marx and Tagore on the wall of his hideout.
Ha, emni ektu klanto bodh korchi.
Ta hobe na? She
থেকে কখন বেরিয়েছ রে ফিল্লে? মা তো তোমার জন্য
As a historian of Indian cinema, the producer of this compilation film feels that the Indian film, even from the days of Dada Saheb Phalke, contributed to India's national pride by just being Indian. Among all the European colonies of the world, in the first half of this century, India was unique in having a national film industry of its own. Dada Saheb Phalke, who made the first Indian feature film in 1913, drew his themes from the inexhaustible treasure trove of Indian mythology. This film on Krishna, made in 1918, demonstrated not only Phalke's technical and aesthetic virtuosity, but also the fact that the Indian film was truly Indian. In the subconscious sphere, the medium virtually became the message, resurrecting India's pride in its tradition and culture, unique among all colonies dominated by Western cinema. The tradition of the mythological and devotional films was followed by the most creative filmmakers of the talkie era. The committed Indian filmmaker utilized even the devotional films for indirect introduction of nationalist ideas. Prabhat's film on Sant Eknath, initially titled Mahatma, had to be renamed Dharmatma under official pressure. Featuring Bal Gandharva in the title role, the film brought out Sant Eknath's fight against untouchability. And then there were some daringly direct political films advocating the Indian cause. When Hitler was committing a genocide of 6 million Jews, the British administration in India was killing 500,000 brown Indian natives of Bengal by sheer callousness. K.A.Abbas made an authentic film on the Bengal famine and touched the Indian conscience with his Dharti Ke Lal. With music by Ravi Shankar, this stage sequence calls for the unity of India.
कोटरियों में गाजे बैठे बनिए सराना कोटरियों में गाजे बैठे बनिए सराना
सुंदर नारी भूख मारी बेचे घर घर ला सुंदर नारी भूख मारी बेचे घर घर ला
चौपट नगरी वान संभाले चौपट नगरी वान संभाले चार तरफ पहुंचाते साथी चार तरफ पहुंचा
Abbas had also written a film script for the giant of Indian cinema, V. Shantaram, who not only produced and directed Dr. Kotnis Ki Amar Kahani, but also performed its title role. This extract from the biographical film shows how Dr. Kotnis took leave of his father on the eve of his historic journey to China in response to a call from Jawaharlal Nehru.
उनके दरमियान खड़े हुए हमारे एक नेता जोश भरी आवाज से कह रहे थे बहनों
और भाइयों जापान ने चीन पर जो जो जुल्म ढाए हैं उनसे आप बेखबर नहीं जरा सोचो कि उस दुखी चीन की जिसके लाखों अनाथों और विधवाओं की कलेजा तोड़ देने वाली चीख पुकार से दुनिया कांप उठी धरती थर्रा कर रह गई उस पड़ोसी मुल्क की मदद करना क्या हमारा फर्ज नहीं
लोगों ने जोश से जवाब दिया।
तो आओ मेरे प्यारे भाइयों, हम सब मिलकर उस दुखी देश की सेवा करें। जहां तक बन पड़े कई एक सेवक दवाइयां और मदद का जरूरी सामान वहां भेजकर अपना फर्ज अदा करें, अपने हमदर्दी का सबूत दें।
इसके साथ ही लोगों ने हजारों रुपए चंदे के तौर पर दे दिए। उस पर नेता ने फिर दर्द भरी आवाज से कहना शुरू किया, बड़ी अच्छी बात है
कि आप हर तरह से मदद करने को तैयार हैं, मगर प्यारे भाइयों, हमें सामान और रुपए से भी कहीं ज्यादा डॉक्टरों की जरूरत है। क्या आप लोगों में कोई ऐसे डॉक्टर मौजूद है जो अपने पड़ोसी मुल्क के करोड़ों जख्मियों की मरहम पट्टी के लिए अपनी जान पर खेलकर लड़ाई के मैदान में चीन जाने को तैयार हो?
हजारों के हजारों चुपचाप और खामोश रह गए। एक सन्नाटा सा छा गया। उस पर नेता ने फिर आवाज बुलंद की,
है कोई ऐसा देशभक्त?
और मैंने कहा, हाँ।
आपका नाम?
द्वारकानाथ कोटनीस।
द्वारकानाथ कोटनीस। आपका शहर?
शोलापुर।
शोलापुर। डॉक्टर द्वारकानाथ? कोटनीस? शोलापुर?
One Indian filmmaker dared it to the real extreme of incorporating the message of the freedom struggle woven into the fabric of his film to such an extent that it angered the British administration, prompting them to ban the film shortly after release. K.Subrahmanyam's Tamil film, Tyagabhumi, was revolutionary for its times, not only in terms of its direct political message, but also as the high water mark of the spirit of liberation of the Indian woman in any Indian film of its time. Discarded by her wealthy husband, a poor girl is elevated to a wealthy life by circumstances. The husband returns to claim his legal rights of matrimony. Appearing in court, the girl not only refuses to accept him, but also offers him an alimony to support himself.
சினிமா
The law in 1939, the year of the film, compels her to join her husband. She chooses courting arrest in the cause of national freedom instead of being imprisoned in her unwanted husband's household. When unofficial news leaked out that the film was about to be banned, the patriotic filmmaker, with the cooperation of the cinema owners, threw open the gates of the cinemas where the film was being screened and conducted continuous free shows till the moment in the early hours of the next morning when the police seized the film prints. With its unique place in the history of Indian cinema, Tyagabhumi was remembered by a grateful Tamil audience in 1984 by marking the 45th anniversary of the banning of the film, with a nostalgic revival of the film in the same cinema in Madras, where the film was forcefully seized by the British authorities in 1939. The Tamil Nadu Chief Minister, M.G. Ramachandran, and representatives of all political parties paid homage to the memory of the filmmaker, director K.Subrahmanyam.
Thank you.